you twist to fit the mold that I am in. But things just get so crazy living, life gets hard to do. And I would gladly hit the road, get up and go if I knew that someday it would lead me back to you.
Hey guys, so I've got to the library. I decided today that I'd do a different one. Instead of in my house, I'd get out of the house. It's a nicer background, and this library's super nice. So I'm gonna be here for pretty much most of the day, and I'm gonna try to get a bunch done. So it's actually the weekend, the week before we start, and it's been 2 months of nothing. We've been on holiday mode. So I thought I'd, you know, refresh myself, check emails, check what's the actual curriculum. Neurology's apparently a really hard block, so I wanna have a good look and a good overview of what I'm going to expect this year. I've got pretty much the whole room to myself, which is brilliant. And I've got a lot of things on my checklist, which I have to sort of go through. So I'll get out the laptop and start getting into it. So usually I'm one to study at home. I have my little sort of study desk that I've set up and it's really nice. But I thought that'd be pretty boring to film. You've seen my room before in plenty of my other videos. So I think this is a lot better, a lot nicer, a lot more different. It's a little after 10:30 and I decided to scope out the course. I'm starting second year of medical school and the first body system we'll be looking at is the nervous system. Our brain, the central nervous system, and the nerves through our body, the peripheral nervous system. Neurology, which is the formal name for it, deals with diseases like Alzheimer's and Parkinson's disease, head trauma, and multiple sclerosis. So to first get a grip on the system, I go through the course outline and I start mapping out the lectures. What's great about the program structure is that every week is focused on a specific topic or theme. For example, in our first week, we learn about neurological development, which encompasses neural tube defects like spina bifida. And in other weeks, we focus on vascular issues or demyelinating diseases like multiple sclerosis. So after getting a good idea on how the next few weeks will run, I quickly check through emails, read through the assessment schedule, and make sure I'm up to date on any administrative tasks I need to complete before Monday. Also, quick tip when studying, I find that music without lyrics really helps me to concentrate, and 95% of the time you'll find me listening to a lo-fi playlist. When I'm planning on doing a big long day of study, I like to split it up into 1 to 2 hour sessions. So after I've had a quick break scrolling through social media and watching the odd YouTube video, I fill up my water bottle and find a new study spot. I find that when you're in the library the whole day, moving around every now and then makes the whole experience a lot more interesting. Once I'm all nice and comfy, I start revising some of the procedural skills we learned during our hospital days last year. I go through the more basic skills like how to properly take a patient's weight, height, waist circumference, and BMI. When revising content where I'm reading through a slab of text, I like to scribble down the standout points. Even though my handwritten notes are pretty messy and I might not look at them again, I find that the simple act of writing them down helps me to remember it way better. I touch up on my knowledge of vital signs, the Korokov sounds, which to be honest, I can't hear all of them most of the time, and spirometry. Going through spirometry reminds me of all those pesky flow volume loops that we had to stick to memory. And for a minute, I almost hear the soothing voice of John West speaking respiratory physiology to me. But after looking at the long list of skills in hematology and cardiology, I decide to finish on spirometry and I open up Past Medicine to refire my brain with some questions. If you haven't heard about it already, Past Medicine is an excellent resource for medical students at any stage. It provides exam style questions for every body system and is catered to your expected level of knowledge. I worked through the anatomy questions for neurology, and even though we haven't been formally taught about the nervous system as of yet, I like to do the questions anyways because at the end of each section, you're provided with a well-explained answer along with extra information covering everything related to the topic. As you can see, I like to have a second page where I create mini questions on anything I found tricky or think will be assessed. After trialing with making notes last year, I found the process of just typing everything up or writing everything up just takes way too long. And now I opt to copy and paste whatever information I need, so whether that be through Past Medicine or a textbook, and I stick it in a convenient location so I can look back and revise on it. Fingers trace your every outline, oh yeah, yeah, yeah. Paint a picture with my hands. I head over to the nearby shops and grab a quick sandwich from Subway, then head straight back to the library to get out of the 44 degree heat. With the library super quiet, I find another cozy little spot by the window, and I decide that I should probably learn a little bit more about nervous system anatomy, as well as some common neurological conditions. The blood supply to the brain seems like a pretty good place to start, and I stare real long and hard to try put terms like the superior cerebellar artery and anterior communicating artery into my brain. Lacuna stroke comes up, and I find that the meaning is in the name because following the ischemic event, the damaged brain forms cysts that look like lakes. And lacuna originates from the Latin word lacus. I probably said that wrong, my bad, but it means lake. And I think to myself that learning Latin in high school wouldn't have been such a bad idea. The time quickly passes by, and I finish up by going through some Anki flashcards until the library closes. If you've never come across Anki, it's a really, really good digital flashcard system to help you remember pesky little facts or difficult pieces of information. And it's been extremely useful for me for my knowledge retention. There's plenty of videos online praising Anki and giving guides for it, so I definitely consider checking them out. They announce that the library's closing soon, so I start packing my things and make my way home. Alright guys, so I'm back home now. The library closed at 4:30, so as soon as that hit, we all left. And I've made my way back, and it's really hot outside. It's 44 degrees right now, so the Australian summer is absolutely brutal. But I got most of the objectives that I wanted to do completed. As you saw, I still have a little bit left more of the Anki deck that I want to finish off, and I'll probably plan to do a little bit more past med questions just to revise on my previous block, cardiovascular, just to give us a bit of a refresher. But I'm gonna meet my friend later, so a few more hours of hard work, and then I can just relax for the rest of the evening. Alright guys, so I am off to go bouldering with my friend. I've done rock climbing in the past, but not really properly bouldering, so it should be good fun. But that will bring us to the end of the study day. I feel like I got a lot done, and I'm pretty excited to get underway with next week. I'll have plenty more content regarding med stuff soon, away from all the holiday stuff. But if you like the video, can you please chuck us a like? That really helps, and subscribe to see more stuff like this. But until next time, this was Sebastian. Stay sharp. I'ma need a second. Woo! All this liquor got me second guessing. Yeah, yeah. Now we 5 shots deep. Now we 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 shots deep. I'ma need a second. Woo! All this liquor got me second guessing. Yeah, yeah. Now we 5 shots deep. Now we 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 shots deep. Yeah, yeah. Coming through late. Homie sent an addy, so you know I'm on the way. Pull up to the gate, you already bought.